Well, last time we were here, we had Lou Stonebridge on keyboards, and Lou was with us last time we played the Half Moon Putney, but the time before that, it was Pete Fillion on keyboards. Tonight, it's Rob Millis on keyboard.
Thank you.
Now, Rob gets the gig because not only is he an exceptionally good keyboard player, but he doesn't have a house in the Caribbean or the south of France, which were the other two.
There's nothing wrong with Twickenham, Dave.
I know, exactly. Yeah. No, Pete Fillion spends half his life in Montserrat. Lou Stonebridge spends half his life in the south of France. And I'm obviously paying them too much.
Mind you, Lou lived in Twickenham, with his hope, yeah.
Yes, Lou. I am. Yeah, this one is it's one that Lou Stonebridge and I wrote at the beginning of this century for a blues band album, the title of which I don't remember. But it was the one around 2000. No, long after that. The one with the leg on the cover.
Stepping out,
there you go.
I used to sell them. I'm a prosthetist.
Yeah, this one is, Lou and I wrote this. It's called I Am the Blues, and it's not I Am, it's written from the perspective of the blues as an entity.
Yeah.
where you stay sharp, I'm still around. Wherever passion and soul is found. Tony, Jimmy, Stevie Ray, who knows what they might be doing today? I'm the blue. Song that the Allman Brothers took over, as they did Stage for Blues, and in 1980 the blues band, we found ourselves on the same label as the reformed Allman Brothers. Well, they weren't reformed, they had reformed. And we were asked to tour with them as the opening act, which was a lot of fun. By then the great Dwayne Allman had been killed in a motorbike accident, as had Barry Oakley, so they'd lost their slide player and their harmonica player. Luckily for them, the support act had a slide player and a harmonica player. So about the second or third night, Dickie Betts and Greg came into our dressing room and asked Paul and I if we would go up and play on Stage for Blues with them, which we did. A lot of fun. Some nights, suddenly there'd be a Hammond organ playing on Someday Baby, and I'd turn around and Greg would be there, and it was a fun tour. I say this is another one that they took over. Sonny Boy Williamson's song called One Way Out.
Thank you.
this one is one of the tracks on my triple CD album. It's the retrospective. And this is one that was on the Feels Right album originally, but on this one it's a live version from a previously unreleased from the Montreux Jazz Festival in 1983. Just the other day. It's a song comes from Delbert McClinton. It's called Two More Bottles of Wine. Sadly died before he could record it, and I just thought the way Stax Records would have done it. I mean, there's some fantastic recordings of it by so many different artists, but I always thought everyone took it a bit too quick, and Stax were taking it a bit slower. And on our version, we got Zoot Money playing the organ, recorded at Rob's studio on that very.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
machine there.
I should have left the settings as soon as
done. Anyway, I think you'll recognise it.
So blind, well, I'm blind. Thank you very much. We'll take a short break. If you want to get your CDs over here. Thank you.
This one is one of the tracks on my triple CD album. It's the retrospective. And this is one that was on the Feels Right album originally, but on this one it's a live version from previously unreleased from the Montreux Jazz Festival in 1983. Just the other day. So the song comes from Delbert McClinton. It's called Two More Bottles of Wine. Chicks did a nice version. Who else has done it? Anyway, we can do it now. As long as I remember the first line.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
Yeah. Hear me now. Scene. No, I'm not playing.
One, two, three.
Thank you.
You better. see you, baby, you're something else. Every time I see you, honey, you're somewhere else.
Thank you. I hope you had as much fun as we did.